In this video, I will give you one tip to memorize anatomical terminology. I know when you take anatomy classes, there are a bunch of memorizing. You have to remember muscle, you have to remember blood vessels, nervous tissue, internal organs. And maybe you are wondering, you don't know what to do. You don't have any idea what to remember first. So here is a tip I can give you. My suggestion is memorize bone first. Bone or bony landmark. Here is why. This is tibia. Okay, this is lower leg, right? This is fibula. Fibula. Okay, there are many bones and bony landmarks, but let's get over this memorization. This is real basic. Okay, this is tibia. This is fibula. Once you memorize name of bone and the landmark of bone, it's relatively easy to memorize muscle, nerve, and blood vessels. Let's see. This is muscle. Okay, this muscle is in the lateral part of leg. This muscle attaches to fibula. So, name of this muscle is fibularis longus. Fibularis longus, because this muscle is related to fibula. Huh, that makes sense. Then, there's deep muscle that attaches to tibia. What is this blue one? This is tibialis posterior. Tibialis posterior. And there is tibialis anterior on anterior part. Tibialis anterior. Huh. So it's easy when you memorize bone first. Now you can compound more things like muscle, tibialis posterior, tibialis anterior, fibularis longus, right? But good thing is there, more, okay? I was talking about how to memorize muscles, right? But you can apply this logic for nervous tissue. Let's see, what do I mean? You see this nerve? This is on posterior part of leg. This yellow one. This is close to tibia. So, what is the name of this nerve? This is tibial nerve. Tibial nerve. Then, this nerve here. This nerve is on lateral part. It's close to fibula. So, common fibular nerve. Common fibular nerve. See this logic? Once you memorize name of bone and name of landmark, it's easy to memorize other tissues, such as muscle tissues, nervous tissues, and blood vessels. Let's see, this is part of femur. Femur. What kind of tissues around femur? There is rectus femoris, that's muscle. Rectus femoris. Femoris is a meaning of femur, right? How about other tissues? Femoral vein. Femoral vein or artery. Femoral vein, femoral artery. That's blood vessels. Femoral nerve. Femoral nerve. See, these names are related to bone. That's why I'm giving you advice that you memorize bony tissue first. Of course, this logic does not always apply for memorizing terminology, because some name of muscles don't apply for this logic. Let's see. This is flexor hallucis longus. Flexor hallucis. Hallucis means a big toe. longest, no name for bony landmarks, right? But this is high tendency. There is name of bone in some tissues, such as rectus femoris, femoral artery, femoral nerve. Do you see this relationship? So let's go to the next part. Let's see upper extremity. This is forearm. This is radius. Radius. This is ulna. Let's see nervous tissue. This nerve is on radial side. Thus, this is radial nerve. Radial nerve. This nerve is on ulna part. This is ulna nerve. Ulna nerve. As I said, this logic doesn't apply 100% times. Like, this nerve is median nerve. Median nerve. There's no name or bony landmarks. See that? This logic doesn't apply always, but this is high tendency. Ulna. Ulna nerve. Radius. Radial nerve. If you look name of muscles, there's like a flexor carpi ulnaris. Flexor carpi ulnaris, because this muscle is on ulna side. See, that is why I emphasize that you should memorize bony tissue first. Then let's go to scapula. Okay, this is scapula. Okay, then there are many landmarks in scapula. Like, let's see. There's concave surface around here. This is infraspinal fossa. Infraspinal fossa. Fossa means concave surface. What is infra and spinous? There is spine of scapula right here. This is spine of scapula. Spine. So, infraspinal fossa means inferior from spine, okay? Infra, inferior from spine. Huh, that makes sense. Then, what kind of muscle attaches here? You can suggest a name. This is infraspinal fossa. Thus, muscle is infraspinatus. Infraspinatus. This is famous rotator cuff muscle. And there is infra, there should be supra. This bony landmark is supraspinal fossa. Supraspinal fossa. There's muscle from here. Supraspinal fossa. What is it? That is supraspinatus. See, terminology of bony structures is important to memorize muscle and nerve. Let's see, I would like to introduce one nerve. There's one nerve passing like this. This nerve is very relatively on upper part of scapula. Thus, this is suprascapular nerve. Suprascapular nerve. Supra means above. Then, this nerve is related to scapula. That is why this is suprascapular nerve. Ah, very important to memorize bony tissues. Then for the last picture, I'm going to explain the anterior part of scapula. This is anterior view. I want to explain this part. This is coracoid process. Coracoid process. There's one muscle that attaches to coracoid process and humerus. By the way, this is humerus. What is this muscle? This is coracobrachialis. Coracobrachialis. Brachium means arm, humerus. You know, it's different name, but that same thing. Brachium and humerus means same thing. So this is coracobrachialis. This is name of muscle. Then this ligament that's between coracoid process and humerus. What is it? This is coracohumeral ligament. Coracohumeral ligament. I cannot emphasize enough. You should memorize bony structures first. Then it's easy to memorize other tissues. I know memorizing bony tissue is still hard to do at first time, but this is real basic. Really, really basic. Once you get over basic, there is fun practical application. You can learn the new method of your profession, like a physiotherapy method and training method. Once you get over basic, there's fun world is waiting for you. So I hope this video helps to memorize anatomical terminology. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.